This is the Urus, the world's fastest SUV. It's also a bit of a challenging concept because Lamborghini's job is to produce the world's loudest and most outlandish supercars, right? Not five-door sensible crossovers with a big boot. So the question is this car just a rebodied Audi Q7 with a big engine, or are we going to find some actual supercar DNA? Well, I'm currently driving off-road in a Lamborghini. It's a bit of a strange feeling, but one that's not entirely surprising when you consider that the Urus has permanent four-wheel drive with a 60-40 front rear torque split. It's got Pirelli Scorpion off-road tyres, those are optional. It's got decent ground clearance, and you've got three dedicated off-road modes down here that jack up the air suspension. What it's also got up there is a 4-litre twin turbo V8. And I know what you're thinking, you're sitting at home crying into your keyboard because it's not a highly strung V10 or V12, well, you're gonna have to get over it. And this is gonna cheer you up because this particular twin turbo V8 has 641 horsepower and 627 pounds-feet of torque available from just over 2000 RPM. This is mental. Lamborghini told us we were gonna be driving on an off-road course. I thought we'd be creeping over boulders, but this appears to be a rally stage. Let's be realistic here. How many people that actually buy the Urus are gonna drive it off-road? None, probably, which is why it's much more important that we drive this car on the public road, or even better, on a racetrack, because that's where we can find out what an SUV capable of 0-62 in 3.6 seconds and 189 miles an hour flat out actually feels like. So here we go then, third gear, coming out of this corner. Quite quick then. It's quite interesting, that noise as well, isn't it? It doesn't bark or shriek like you get in the Aventador or the Huracan for obvious reasons. It's much more woofly and rumbly than that. And those are definitely words. But don't worry, it will still do cracks and pops and all sorts on downshifts and gets a much harder edge note as it approaches the 6,800 RPM line. Basically, don't worry, you're gonna get noticed in this thing. As for the handling, well, Lamborghini has thrown absolutely everything at this car to ensure that it batters physics into submission. So we've got four-wheel steering, we've got active anti-roll bars, we've got torque vectoring via a centre diff and a rear diff. And this car, because we're tonking around a racetrack, has got Pirelli P0 coursers on it. All you need to know is that all that makes a 2.2 ton SUV feel much smaller, much lighter, much more agile than it really should. The carbon ceramic rotors you get on this, as standard, are the biggest carbon ceramic brakes on any production car. It just baffles the mind. Now the brake pedal, it does have a bit of a squidgy feel. I think that's to help you modulate them when you're out on the road. But honestly, back yourself, stand on them, and they will stop you dead every single time. Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, this isn't particularly representative of my school run. And I hear you. So we have taken this car out on the public road, and I can confirm it will do all the mundane stuff quietly and comfortably. The fast SUV is inherently flawed. It has too much weight, it's too big, the center of gravity is too high, and yet Lamborghini have just laughed in the face of that and said, we don't care. We're gonna make a car that handles like a sports car, despite looking like an off-roader. Off. Hats off to them. Bit of a tricky one this, because there's a massive gap between admiration and love. I absolutely admire what Lamborghini has achieved here with the Urus. It's brutally fast, it's the sharpest SUV we've ever driven, and there's actual space inside and it will do the boring stuff with ease. But if I'm honest, it's the hairy ass supercars and the groundbreaking electric cars that this thing is going to finance that I'm holding out for.